Thinking is important, but what's more important is doing. I can plan and make a video as much as I want and put all this thought and effort into it and make it the most robust, bulletproof plan. But throughout the process, plans always change. And it's the video making that takes up the 90% of your time. The 90% then changes your perspective of the original plan. So fuck it. I think I need to stop thinking so hard on the plan and just focus more on doing. How's my first month been on YouTube? Terrible. I may have overestimated myself, but I'm not slowing down. And on this channel, we know they have weird philosophies. New philosophy. What is a philosophy, actually? How do you even spell philosophy? Oh, that's phyllo pastry. Oh, philosophy. Okay, that's better. The study of fundamental questions about existence, knowledge, values, reasons, the mind, and language. Okay, I'd say it's a philosophy. I have a new weird philosophy. You don't speed up by slowing down. And what do I mean by that? Well, I'll go back to the start to help you understand a little more. And no way you're thinking, why have a mustache? I have a mustache because I'm getting paid. This is for a TV show. You have a mustache because you're stupid. So about a month ago, I had a job as a house paint mixer. That job was so mundane and so boring and so easy. Every day my brain would configure new ways and new ideas and new videos to create to escape that life. And through that, my dreams weren't forged because I already had the ideas long ago, but they were definitely solidified. Because of how much that position and job taunted me, being the same forever. Honestly, the thought of not being thought by everyone, the thought of not being remembered, the thought of not being a super funny, charismatic, smart, yet charming, well-rounded guy that everyone would look up to. My imagination forced itself to become resourceful. And through that, I genuinely believe that my video ideas were better then. And because of it, I made videos that I was actually proud of. Upon this past month, I've deleted so many videos because I think all the ideas are trash because I can't come up with them anymore. Everyone's average. When I say everyone, I mean like honestly 90% of people, and that's not bad. That's not bad at all. That's not even remotely bad. Being average isn't bad, it's just a fact. But I want things to be written about me. I want to be remembered. Before I quit a month ago, I had a 40-hour job. And the issue with having a 40-hour job is that it's very limiting in terms of time. You have so many different things to worry about. There's family, physical fitness, there's friends. And not to mention the part that takes up the biggest portion, the girlfriend. And there's only so much mental and physical energy for you to juggle all of them. But hey, I did a pretty good job. So I thought, what if we dial one of these down a bit to make room for the rest? So I decided to slow down the pace of my work to make room for more YouTube videos. Get a more flexible job that allows me to have the time and energy to make more videos and to do also these other things that I've been missing out on. Because I lack consistency. The goal is to make a continuous line of videos weekly. Fast forward to now, I left my job, bought a Toyota Aqua, and I now do Uber. It pays way better than my old job. And in so many ways, it is a blessing, and I definitely think that I'm using it to its full advantage. To make the same amount of pay as my old job, you would need to work 25 hours instead of 40 hours. Which, when you weigh it up, is a really good factor in why you should do Uber. I get to decide what time I want to wake up. I get to decide if I want to go to work that day, and if I don't feel like it, I just don't have to go. I get to decide what music I get to play, what podcast I get to play. I get to decide when my lunch breaks are. I get to decide how long my lunch break is. So you would think that because I'm making more money per hour, I would be making more money per week. Wrong. The truth is I make the same amount of money per week. I just work less hours. It's in human nature to seek the easy way out. I get to wake up whenever I want. I get to go to the gym twice a day because it's fun. I get to wake up slowly and eat breakfast. There is no rush to be anywhere. And through this, I've lost myself and forgotten why I've started. I've become too comfortable and life has been way too easy. I no longer want... This is dumb to say, and this is like stupid and first world and sport of me to say, but I no longer want to escape the 9 to 5 because I guess technically I've escaped. There is no drive for me anymore to create any video to change the disposition of anyone's point of view on a certain topic, or there's no controversy that I want to spill because my life is so calm and chill and easy that it's making me sad, bro. It is destructive. It is not good for me. I miss the pressure. I no longer have that burning desire to prove everyone wrong and create videos, because I'm in no position where I want to escape. Well, I want to escape now because it's making me sad, but you get what I mean. Put it this way. You don't figure out what you want by getting what you want. You don't figure out what you want by scrolling on your phone and eating chips and playing it safe and being calm and chilling. And you don't decide what you want by getting what you want and slowing down and taking the pace. You decide what you want by understanding what you don't want. If you don't want a 9-to-5 job, you go work that 9-to-5 job and you really understand why you don't want it and why you want to escape. And you speed up. You pivot and you move to fit that 9-to-5 job until you can officially escape. But I don't think you should slow down. Hope this all makes sense. I hope that it goes somewhere, because most of my videos I just ramble on and on. But I hope it goes somewhere. If I was to recommend anyone wanting to escape their job, don't slow down. Don't make things easy on yourself. The pressure is why you want what you want, and it's why you also have what you have. You consistently achieve your goals through the pressure, because without the pressure, there is no more goals. So if I were to reverse time, which I can't, but if I were to give it a little bit of advice to anyone, is that it may be hard now, but making it easier is not gonna make it easier. You consistently work through the pressure and it will pay off. Well, live and you learn, I guess. Comfort is the enemy. Goodbye.